speak on. Can you see the screen?
Yes, madam, we can see the screen, madam.
Yeah. Today I am going to share my experience about regenerative medicine for plastic surgeons. Actually, I have been doing this procedures for more than a decade, and I am very happy with the results. And I am sure that by the end of this talk, all of you will agree with me that this therapy should be an important part of your armamentarium. So let's start with the talk on regenerative medicine for plastic surgeons. Friends, first of all, let's see that why we as a plastic surgeon need to know about this regenerative medicine. As all of you are aware that each and every one of us has our own reparative kits within ourselves. God has given us, but we have forgotten it. So these regenerative medicines are a method to harness our own body's part to heal ourselves. And these are one of the part of it. Let's see how it is done. Now, why we should know about this therapies? Because this is the future of medicine. As all of you will agree that stem cell based therapies are now starting to replace the need for more invasive surgeries and even incurable diseases and cancers. Everything is being treated with the stem cells. And these therapies will definitely add a magic potion to your treatment, and more number of people prefer autologous therapy, organic food, everything people they accept easily, and they are more for it. So these therapies, they easily get convinced to get it done, and the results are excellent. And of course, not the least, it helps to build up a huge practice base, which is very important if you are working in a private practice. I will be covering this talk under following heads: introduction, mode of action, preparation, indications. I will show you few clinical cases, and then we will conclude the session. Now, what all therapies are included under regenerative therapies? These are PRP, PRF, IPRF, APRF, biofillers, and combination therapies. I am sure that all of you know about PRP. It's a very common therapy, and in therapy, patients, they come on their own asking for PRP to be done. So let us start with the PRP. PRP is a platelet-rich plasma therapy. It means, in simple words, we can say when there is an abundance of platelet in a concentrated form or a small volume of plasma, it is known as platelet-rich plasma therapy. Then how much should be the concentration of the platelet in the plasma to be effective? The typical baseline of the platelets in our blood is 1.5 to 4 lakhs per microliter. The therapeutic concentration of the PRP can vary anywhere between 3 to 8 folds of the normal level. Now, these are the all branches where PRP have been used. For the first time, it was used in a sports medicine, then orthopedic, dentistry, dermatology, urology. In short, we can say that each and every faculty is using PRP, and day in and day out, new and new indications of PRP are coming out. Now, how it is prepared? PRP is prepared from the patient's own blood. So, of course, it's an autologous source. A specific section of the blood that can be isolated through density gradient centrifugation. Let's have a look at a mode of action. How does it act? What happens is that these platelets, as all of you are aware, this platelet have many granules, which is alpha granules, dense bodies, and all those things. When they get activated, they secrete various growth factors like fibrin growth factors, platelet-derived growth factors, vascular endothelial growth factors, keratinocyte growth factors, epidermal growth factors, and so on. These are few of the factors, main important factors, which I have mentioned in the slide. Apart from this, many other factors are also secreted. So this will initiate the process of healing. So tissue repair, regeneration, cellular proliferation, and healing gets a boost, and it is improved remarkably. Now, when should we use PRP? it should be used to speed up any healing process. Suppose if you have any ulcer, we as a plastic surgeons often get into a situation where we get non-healing ulcer referrals from the orthopedicians, general surgeons and GPs. So we have to do something new so that we can speed up the healing process. So this is a very good procedure. You can add to your therapy in your treatment modality and get the impressive results. Or it can be used along with surgery to promote the faster healing and better recovery. Now, to give you a few of the examples, I use commonly for the hair transplant surgeries. Even during the pre-hair transplant, you can do PRP. During the hair transplant, suppose if there is a grade 4 or 5 baldness and you are planning to cover 50% of the hair and the vertex you are planning for the second sitting, there are lanugo hairs. So what we usually do is that we do the hair transplant and in the vertex and other part we put the PRP. So it has been seen that the growth of the hair is remarkably improved, and post surgery also it can be done. Secondly, most commonly it can be used, suppose those people who are doing cleft lip and cleft palate surgeries. So along with the bone graft, if you put a PRP with the bone graft, then it has been seen that the healing is very fast and the results are excellent. It can be used on its own to stimulate the natural healing process. Now, coming to the method, how it is done. Actually, I'll not go into the details of the method because I assume that all of you know that how it is done, and it's a very simple procedure. And I will just like to share few of the pearls which are associated with each of the steps. First comes the collection. As far as collection is done, few things are to be taken care of. First and foremost thing is that you should ask the patient to come well hydrated. I have seen that if the patient is well hydrated, then we get a better yield of the platelet. Secondly, always inquire whether a patient is fasting or not. If a patient is fasting, don't plan for this procedure. And while withdrawing of the blood, always take a wide bore needle, that is 18 gauge or 16 gauge needle preferably. Because if we go for a thinner needle, then what happens is that the platelets are stimulated and destroyed. So we don't get the very good results. Then comes the processing. As far as processing is concerned, there are various modalities for the processing and methods. The most common which we use is double spin technique. Double spin technique means we centrifuge the collected sample of the blood twice. First, we centrifuge it at the 1500 RPM for 5 minutes. This is known as soft spin. And then we remove the supernant fluid, collect it into the other tube, and then we go for a hard spin. Hard spin means we centrifuge it at the level of 3500 for 15 minutes. By the end of this procedure, we get the PRP. I will show you the picture, how it looks like. Then comes the activation part. This activation part is also very important. In the literature, you will find that people use various products for the activation of the platelets. Like few people use thrombin, few people use calcium chloride solutions. But friends, you will be happy to know that platelets are very fragile and delicate molecules, and they don't need any external activation. What happens is that once you have prepared the platelets, even if you vigorously shake it just before injecting, your platelet is activated. And secondly, the another trick is that most of the time we inject it with a BD syringe or an insulin syringe. So once this passes through the thin bore needle, the platelets itself get activated. And thirdly, suppose if we are injecting in the skin, once we pierce the skin and it comes in the contact with the collagen fibers, this platelet will get auto-activated. So usually I don't add any external activation factor in the PRP therapy. The advantage is that the problems with the use of bovine thrombin, that can be avoided. And secondly, calcium chloride, many a times it's not available, so we don't need any calcium chloride also. Then comes the application. Once we have prepared it, it can be applied by various methods depending on the use. Now, coming to the application part, either you can inject it directly in the skin, or you can use it with ultrasonic massage. You can use it with derma roller, or you can even spray it directly over the raw wound, or you can use it with RF microneedling, fractional CO2, anyway, whichever way you are comfortable. And what is the indication for the PRP, accordingly you have to decide ki how you want to introduce this molecule inside the wound. These are the pictures of the few of the PRP. As you can see, in this conical tube at the bottom, there is a white column. With this are the platelets. This white thing what you can see is a platelet, and above the platelets are platelet poor plasma. So before injecting, you have to shake this vigorously, fill it in the BD syringe or insulin syringe, and immediately inject it. Now, what are the uses of the PRP? PRP can be used. I use it extensively for the hair regrowth problems, for alopecia, acne scars, skin rejuvenation, anti-aging therapy, face lifting, strias, and lichen sclerosis. I mentioned this in the beginning because my practice is mainly of cosmetic surgery and cosmetology. Then, of course, the chronic skin ulcers. These also are the indications for the PRP therapy. Among this, the most common are diabetic chronic wound, diabetic foot, decubitus ulcer, chronic non-healing ulcers, and varicose ulcers. Of course, there are few contraindications for this therapy also. Let's talk about the absolute contraindications. Platelet dysfunction syndrome. Obviously, if the platelet is not functioning well, it's of no use. Don't do PRP. Then comes critical thrombocytopenia. If the number of platelet is less in the blood, then we cannot do the PRP. If a patient is hemodynamically unstable, if a patient is having chronic liver disease, or if he is on anticoagulant therapy, we should defer this therapy. There are few relative contraindications to this therapy. Please pay attention to this point. Consistent use of NSAID within 48 hours of the procedure, you should not do PRP. This is the common mistake which mostly we as a beginner do while doing the PRP. We should always inquire from the patient whether you have taken any NSAID. Many a time it does happen. There is some headache or body ache and patient takes NSAID on its own and he fails to inform us. This will hamper the results of PRP. And another very important point which I have learned after burning my fingers is that what happens is that after injecting PRP, patient will complain, bahut dard ho raha hai, kya kare doctor sahab? And we immediately prescribe NSAID. So please don't do this, because once we do prescribe the NSAID, then we are nullifying the result of PRP. So NSAID use should be avoided. Secondly, we have to always inquire about the corticosteroid treatment, whether he has taken any corticosteroid at the injection site within 1 month, or he is on systemic use of corticosteroid within 2 weeks. Then we should wait for a few weeks and then plan the PRP therapy. If the patient's hemoglobin is less than 10 gram, then also better not to do the PRP. Now coming to the local complication, the complications are not that severe. Patient can have sometimes local bleeding, hematoma, infection, nerve damage, but pain, lack of results. The most common complication is pain and of course lack of results, because preparing PRP, there are various modalities. So one has to do it and then standardize their own results. Once you are able to standardize, then your results will be stable. Other complications in the hands of plastic surgeon, it's not that common. Let's have a look at few of the clinical cases of the PRP. This was a boy, 12 years old. He had a road traffic accident, and following it, the wound was not healing. Secondary suturing was also done. Not willing for any surgery, 2 sessions of PRP was done, and following PRP, you can see the healing. These are few of the cases of burns. in which PRP therapy was given, which of course speeds up the process of the healing. Another case of the burns, what I have seen about the use of PRP in burns is that first advantage is that healing is very fast. Secondly, the quality of scar is good. Thirdly, the adjuvant area of the skin, like hair and sweat glands, and those get stimulated early, so the healing process is fast. This is one of the results of hair loss, because in young patients, many times young patients, and nowadays even young girls are coming with a problem of hair loss or diffuse hair loss, and we cannot do the hair transplant in each and every patient. So if you do a PRP therapy, the results are excellent. Usually I do it once in a month and give 3 sessions along with nutritional supplementation. And the results are so satisfying that patient is very happy. And many a time it does happen that after doing this therapy, after full regrowth, patient is happy. Then again, after 1.5 or 2 years, he notices that there is again a hair fall. He comes on his own looking for you and asks that, doctor, please do the PRP, and the results are good. So friends, the advantages of the PRP are that it is an autologous procedure. It's available, affordable, there is minimum investment, it's safe, and it eliminates the donor transmissible infection. Of course, we get a faster healing, it is easy to use, and it is convenient. So to conclude, this is a natural, safe, and effective therapy to be used. Now we move on to the another modality of the treatment, which is PRF. This PRF is new for many plastic surgeons, and in fact it is very close to my heart. This is platelet rich fibrin therapy. Now, what is platelet rich fibrin therapy? Actually, this is a second generation platelet concentrate, and it was discovered for the first time by Dr. Chokran in 2001, and he was a dentist, and he is the one who has propagated the use of platelet rich fibrin therapy extensively all over the world, and the results are excellent. The therapy is very simple. You will come to know shortly about this. Now, what is this PRF? Basically, this PRF or platelet rich fibrin is a leukocyte and platelet rich fibrin biomaterial with a specific composition and 3-dimensional structure architecture. How we do it? It is a very simple procedure. What we have to do is that we need to withdraw our blood into the test tube without anticoagulant. Please note, no anticoagulant is required for PRF, and then immediately it has to be centrifuged at the rate of 33,000 RPM for 13 minutes. The resultant product, what you will get is a topmost layer of the platelet poor plasma, which we commonly call as PPP. In between the white portion, what you are seeing is a PRF clot, which is of our use, and in the bottom is the RBC in the tube. A few things I would like to mention regarding the use of the PRF. First and the foremost thing is that, friends, never ever use glass tubes, because the glass will initiate the coagulation process fast and you will not get good PRF results. Secondly, speed is extremely important in this procedure. So see to it that the centrifuge and other things are in the vicinity of the patient. Immediately you have to centrifuge. Once you withdraw it, always withdraw with a wide bore needle, 18 gauge or 16 gauge. And then immediately it has to be centrifuged, and then immediately it has to be used to get the better results. These are the two important points which need to be taken care of for the PRF therapy. Again, it's a diagrammatic representation. As you can see that the upper portion is platelet poor plasma or acellular plasma. In between you will get a very good fibrin clot, which is platelet rich fibrin. And at the bottom of the tube is RBCs. Now, how does it act? It helps in tissue regeneration, tissue rejuvenation, induction of cell differentiation, extracellular matrix formation, and increase in collagen production. Indications, almost it is same as PRP. You can use anywhere where the when the wound is not healing, and for skin rejuvenation extensively it has been used for post acne scars, for dental procedures, for non healing sinus, or if you are doing bone graft for some procedures in plastic surgery, you can combine it with PRF and you will see the wonders happening. So these are the main indications of the PRF, and or in nutshell, I can say that basically it can be used anywhere to improve and speed up the healing process and to get the better scar post healing. This is the picture how the PRF looks. It's a thin, flimsy, jelly-like column. And another important practical tip I would like to say, that always hold it either with a plain forceps or with a artery forceps. Don't hold it with a tooth forceps. Otherwise, the fluid will exudate and our result will be hampered. And while removing the PRF from the tube with a plain forceps, first initially gently dislodge the column from the side of the tube with a long plain forceps and gently lift up the PRF. Now, how we can use it? It can used in a gel form. Gel form, it can be used either you have to directly smear up, or if you are having a wound which has a cavity, or if there is a sinus, then you can pack this gel inside that sinus. Or it can be used in a membrane form. There are some products or the instruments available by which you can form the membrane. Or what I do is that you just compress it in between the two collagen sheets and the membrane is ready and it can be used directly. Or it can be used with the bone material, as I have mentioned you earlier. And of course, it can be used with collagen granules also. It can be used either on the superficial wound or it can be used to pack the deep cavities. So the advantages of PRF over PRP is that this is non-allergic, autologous, physiological product. Of course, it eliminates the donor-related infection. And yes, friends, it's a biological glue for the tissue adhesion. Let's have a look at few of the clinical cases. These are few of the interesting cases which I would like to share with you all. Each case has a story behind it. This was a young girl, 13 years old. In fact, she is a daughter of my close friend. She had a pilonidal sinus and she was operated twice for the pilonidal sinus. And she came to me with a frustrated with non-healing wound. So, this was my first case of the PRF. So what I did was that I told her that this PRF therapy can be done and the results are good. I expect the results are good. If you are willing, we'll go for this therapy. Since she has tried many loads of antibiotics and local ointments, she said, okay, we'll do it since it's an autologous product and there is no problem. So why not we go for this therapy? As you can see, this was the PRF which was prepared and then it was introduced, and I put the PRF and I called her on the fourth day for the dressing, and this was the result, and I was myself astonished looking at the result and was very happy. And then day in and day out I started doing this procedure and propagating about this procedure. As you can see in this picture, the column size almost I think 3 to 3.5 to 4 centimeter of the sinus size was that which healed miraculously. What you have to do is that after putting this column, you have to seal it with a dry collagen. I usually prefer a dry collagen over the wet collagen, so that whatever fluid or exudate is there, it remains localized to that area and is gradually imbibed in the tissue, and it helps in the better healing rather than putting directly Sofratrol or the gauze paste. This is another case of post-acne scar. For her, we did a few sessions of the derma roller, and following that, we just applied the PRP and sealed it for 30 minutes and then left it. This was another young lady. She came with a road traffic accident, and she was getting married in on fourth day. So we just applied a PRP, and after fourth day, you can see the results. This is another interesting case. This is a lady, 35 years old. She had a road traffic accident. Following which, she developed a hematoma over the scalp. This hematoma got infected into the abscess, for which general surgeon did IND. Following which, she developed a open. She had this calvarial bone was exposed. So she went to a neurosurgeon. And then somebody has tried a secondary suturing. As you can see the scar marks, this was on 6th of April. And patient was not willing for any surgery or rotation flap or any surgical intervention. And she was anemic also. Her hemoglobin was on the lower side. In spite of being low hemoglobin on lower side, I started her on oral hematinic. And along with that, I did this PRF therapy. As you can see that on the 6th of April, we did the PRF therapy. And you can see the result of the wound. You can see granulation appearing on 10th. It is nothing less than a miracle. And on the 20th of April, the wound is granulated well. This is the same on 6th of April. And final result on 27th of May, the whole wound healed on its own, and no intervention was required. This was another interesting case. This was an unstable scar post this skin grafting donor area. First, I will tell you a little about the story about this case. This patient was about 60 years old. He had undergone for the CABG surgery, and following this bypass surgery on 6th of October 2017, following which he had a non-healing wound over the vein graft site, and for which VAC therapy was applied. Scooping was in December, VAC therapy was applied. Then scooping was done in March 2018. Placentrax was applied for 1 month. And since then, he was on continuous dressing. Then he came to us, and we thought of going for PRF therapy. And this was on, as you can see, on 24th of February, we did the PRF therapy. And by the 15th of January, the wound healed completely, and he was very happy, so was we. For a diffuse hair loss, again, this is excellent therapy, gives a very good results. How does it help? What it does is that, first of all, it will reduce the hair fall. Secondly, it will improve the quality of the existing hair. Thirdly, if there is a hair fall and a patient comes to you within 6 months, this means the follicles have gone dormant. They are not destroyed completely. So with this PRF, you are going to stimulate those follicles and the hair starts regrowing. And once the hair starts regrowing and converts into terminal hair, then it lasts easily for 5 to 6 years. This is my personal experience, what I have seen. Now, coming to the next therapy, this is IPRF. IPRF means injectable PRF. It is also proposed with the same concept.
Excuse me, madam. Before we go to the rest of the things, shall we take a few questions regarding this one?
Sure.
Okay, madam. Just a second. Yeah, as such in the chat box, there are no questions have come. But let me just ask you a few things on behalf of everyone. Regarding the PRP, madam, you said that you will be doing sessions. How often do you do the sessions?
PRP, usually I do every 3 weeks, one session.
Every 3 weeks you do a session?
Yeah.
And how do you decide the volume that you use for PRP?
volume usually depending on the extent of the lesion, we decide the volume required for the PRP. Suppose if a patient is having a small wound 5 by 5 centimeter, then 2 to 3 ml of PRP is enough. For the diffuse hair loss on the scalp, usually I take in a 3 tubes and I need around 8 to 10 cc of the PRP.
Oh, 8 to 10 cc of PRP.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah.
Another interesting thing that we have found is when we are doing hair transplant, we find that the ooze from that scalp is much less, and the next day you find that the scalp is very clean after actually injecting PRP. Yeah. But then there we are actually using almost 15 cc of PRP.
Okay.
For because as such we want PRF also. So sorry, PPP. So because then we take 15 cc of PRF PRP and then we are injecting that. So we get excellent results.
Yeah.
And can you just highlight how you actually use PRF for scalp?
See, what I do for PRF is that suppose we do the micro needling or we do the derma roller therapy. Okay. You do the derma roller and just you spare off that PRF over the scalp. So what happens is that all the fluid will exudate and it will get absorbed. And then I immediately wrap it with a cling wrap.
Okay.
And it is kept for minimum half an hour.
Okay.
So that it gets absorbed inside the through this multiple pricks and it acts wonderfully. Similarly, you can use it on the face also. In face, you can use derma roller. On the scalp also, you can use derma roller. Or you can do fractional CO2 laser. Or even if you do not have any derma roller or fractional CO2, you can use simple this BD syringe and multiple pricks if you do. If there is a limited area like under eye region or anyway, you can use this. Or with RF microneedling also, you can use this PRF therapy.
So face, how do you actually keep it, retain it? I mean, the scalp, you said you're using cling film, but in face, how do you do it?
Same, similar way. You just apply the cling film and it will stay in the place. But only thing is that patient has to be there for 30 minutes.
Okay, so only thing that nose area and all you just open it.
Nose, everywhere you can put the, nose, nostril, we will keep an opening in the cling wrap.
Okay.
And mouth also, we usually keep it open. Three slits we make, 2 for the nostril and 1 for the mouth.
Okay. And for this one, acne scars, no? Like PRP you inject, but then PRF, what do you do for acne scars?
PRF again, same thing for acne scar. You do the subcision first initially, if there is a deep or superficial scar. And then just you smear off over it and seal it.
Okay, you're on top of it, you're doing. You're not putting anything under that.
No. It is difficult. We cannot inject PRF inside the
correct.
Skin. So that's why it has to be just put it on the top. So that the whatever growth factors and can get absorbed through the skin and it acts.
Okay. And madam, next thing is like when you compare PRP and PRF for the scalp, which do you think is better?
Frankly speaking, PRP is better for the scalp. If a patient is completely bald, or if patient has come with shaved hair, then we can think of PRF therapy. Otherwise, PRP is more easier to do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And how is the volume? Like we know that if you're taking 10 cc of blood, then we get 1 cc of PRP. And comparing that with PRF, how is it, madam? Like how do you...
PRF also, see what happens is that PRF, the main important thing in PRF is that you have to collect the blood immediately. You can collect in 2 tubes or maximum 3 tubes.
Okay.
And immediately it has to be centrifuged. The main limitation with PRF is that we cannot use it over extensive areas.
Okay.
Or in small areas we can use it, or we can do it in multiple sittings.
Okay.
This is one of the limitation of the PRF therapy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, madam. Madam, I think you can please proceed with IPRF, madam.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, we'll go to the IPRF. The IPRF is proposed with the same concept that platelet, white cell, fibrinogen, stem cell in liquid form is produced without any additive or anticoagulant, and it clots after injection. See, basically.
Madam, please make full screen, madam, full screen.
Yeah. Hello.
Please continue, madam.
Yeah. This is another very good modality of the therapy. This is injectable PRF. In this injectable PRF, few practical tips I would like to give you. That the main thing is that, again, the speed is of utmost important. Means you have to keep the patient ready, the syringe ready, keep the wound ready or the part cleaned and draped, and try to prepare it in the same room where you have taken the patient. This is centrifuged at 3700 RPM for 1 minute, and you get a supernant liquid. Immediately withdraw it and then you have to inject it. Basically, this portion is rich in fibrin part. So this therapy I usually use more commonly for the post-acne scars, or even if a patient comes for skin rejuvenation or they are having an aging signs. And if a patient is not affording to go for chemical these fillers because of the cost factor, so this PRF therapy is excellent alternative for the fillers. But the only limitation is that you have to do it twice or thrice to get a better results, and the results usually last for 6 months to 9 months. It varies from patient to patient, but it is very much cost effective therapy. Is it okay? Shall I continue? Hello?
Yes, madam. Yes, madam. Yes, madam.
Now, the another modality of the treatment is APRF. APRF means advanced PRF. In this, along with the PRF, there are monocytes and the WBCs. And the settings are that at 1300 RPM, you have to centrifuge for 8 minutes. And basically, this APRF is in use for more activation of the bone graft. And studies have shown that as compared to other therapies, the vascular endothelial growth factor release, or the portion of vascular endothelial growth factor release, is more in APRF therapy. Now, coming to the advantages of PRF over PRP, the advantages are that in PRF, there is no biochemical handling of the blood, since we are not using any anticoagulant, thrombin, calcium, anything. And it is a very simple and cost-effective procedure.
Madam, your slides are not advancing, madam.
Not advancing?
No, madam.
Let me try again.
It is still in that injectable PRF, that particular slide.
Just a minute, huh? I'll do it again. Yeah,
okay. Now it's come, madam.
Come?
Now it's there. Now we have come to advantages of PRF. Yeah.
Now it is okay?
Yes, madam. Now it is okay, madam.
But I cannot see it. Okay?
Yeah, we are able to see clearly.
Yeah. So the advantages of PRF over PRP is that there is no biochemical handling of the blood. It's a simple, cost-effective procedure and favorable healing because of slow polymerization. Means what happens is that in PRF, there is a release of growth factors for the prolonged period of time as compared to PRP. And more efficient cell migration and proliferation. And PRF, it has been seen that PRF has a supportive effect on the immune system also, and it does helps in the hemostasis of the wound. As Dr. Sudeep just mentioned, that in hair transplant we see there is less of the oozing. So this is also one of the advantage of this therapy. Now, coming to the another interesting modality of the treatment, this is the biofiller. See, we have mentioned about injectable PRF. Now, this is biofiller. In biofiller, you can get a bulk of filler element using from your own blood. And then you can inject it and use it as a filler for face rejuvenation, or even if a patient comes with depressed scars or post-acne scars, or if there are very thin scars over any part of the body, or if patient wants rejuvenation in the hand, you can use it, these biofillers. The only thing is that one need to learn this technique, how to do it. And this is one of the most exciting medical aesthetic procedure, but still it is developing. It is not that popular. And it involves the auto transfer with a plasma gel injection derived from the patient's own blood, and it excludes all the risk of the allergic reactions. Indications of this are for face and neck rejuvenation. Even I have done in one of the case of breast rejuvenation, for wrinkles and deep fold correction, for butt correction, hand rejuvenation, post-acne scar, and so on. Few of the clinical cases. This was for the face rejuvenation. What we did was that we have injected it and given a ligament support, and as well as injected it in the nasolabial fold area. This was another case. Again, what we did was that we have supported. We have those who are doing fillers. We have injected it on the mid face point CK1, CK2, CK3, and NL1, NL2, and NL3. Along with that, we have done sitting of the fractional CO2 laser later on. Now the protocols I would like to share for the protocols for to the beginners. You can take a picture of this slide. It is very, very important at what speed you have to do the centrifuge, because the results depend on the method of preparing these products. And the machine which I am using is a Remy 8C centrifuge. Now the various combinations of these therapies can be used. Like, you can use PRP with hyaluronic acid. You can use PRP with the fat. It will give very good results. You can use PRP along with PRF. You can use PRF with the bone graft, PRF with collagen, biofiller plus PRP. By permutation and combination, once you start doing this procedure, automatically you will come to know how to use it, and various new combinations can be used. So to conclude, all these therapies are safe, convenient, natural, and effective therapies. And in fact, I would say that it is a modern medicine boon for repair, restoration, and rejuvenation. And friends, I request you all to start doing these procedures, because these are very, very simple procedures and they are extremely rewarding for the patient as well as doctor. Sir, do you want to show me the PRF video?
Yes, madam, please show the videos.
Yeah, I'll show the video of PRF. Yeah. Sharing, ma'am. PRF video. Desktop.
Open करके फिर नीचे से
Are you able to see?
No, madam.
Just a minute, huh? Yeah. I'll stop करना पड़ेगा. Now you are able to see it?
Yes, madam.
Yeah, so I'll start. Yeah. This was a case of road traffic accident, deep abrasion over the lower limb, and this is how the PRF looks like. I just want to show you that how PRF looks like after preparing. This is the column of the PRF. It's a very thin, flimsy. You have to hold it properly and try to remove the RBC concentrate at the lower border. Or what you can do is that you can cut it with a sharp scissors, also the lower part of the RBC, and then you just smear it off over the wound.
Madam, the video is not progressing, madam. Video is stuck at that particular position.
it's okay. I'll play it again.
Uh-huh.
I'll play it again.
Yeah, okay.
Now, is it progressing?
No, madam.
No?
No, no, no.
Just a minute.
It is progressive.
Okay, then something is wrong with my screen.
Just a minute, huh? I'll show it again.
No, if others are able to see the video progressing, then it is fine.
Just a minute. Huh? It's a very small video. I would like to show you to give you an idea.
Now it is progressing. Now I am nervous. Yeah.
See, this is a PRF which we have prepared, and this is the column which looks like PRF column. It's a thin, shiny, delicate column. Fold it with a plain forceps, fine one, and try to remove the RBC from the bottom of the column. Or what you can do is that even you can cut it with the scissors to detach the RBC portion, and then it has to be smeared on the wound directly. It will keep on oozing the fluid which is inside it. And as per your requirement, as we are having two lesions over here, so we have divided it into two parts, and just smear it over there and press a collagen over it, so that what happens is that it gives a good matrix layer also for the wound healing, and the results are very good and excellent with this therapy. If a patient is having non-healing wound, you should of course consider for this therapy. If there are any questions, they can ask any questions. Otherwise, I will move on to my another talk of melanocyte transfer.
Okay. Madam, can you just tell something further about biofillers, madam?
See, the biofiller therapy is what we do is that you have to withdraw the blood in the similar way we do for PRP with a wide bore needle, okay? And then 15 cc of this blood will give you a biofiller of 3 to 4 cc, okay? So what you have to do is that you have to withdraw the blood in a same PRP tube. That means the tube with the anticoagulant, okay? And then you have to centrifuge it at a slow soft spin. Soft spin means for 1500 RPM for 15 minutes. Okay. So what you will get is that you will get three layers. The upper portion will be platelet poor plasma, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the mid portion will be a buffy coat of platelet rich plasma, and lower down will be the RBC. Okay. And another one important point I would like to tell you is that suppose we have done this soft spin, and after doing the spin, you see that there is no definitive demarcation between three zones. So what you have to do is that you have to again mix it, shake it, and again re-centrifuge it. This demarcation is very important. Okay.
Okay.
So what you have to do is that you have to take this platelet poor plasma with the help of another needle into a separate tube.
Okay.
And then this has to be incubated at 70 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes.
Okay.
So basically what happens is that there are this protein platelet poor plasma. It is having protein in it, so it coagulates. Okay.
Okay.
In the similar way, like with the egg coagulates, once we start boiling it, the same principle. The protein coagulates, but the thing is that you should see to it that the coagulation should not be hard. It should be semi-soft so that we are able to inject it properly. So after 30 minutes, we get this picture. I have shown you the picture of that. Shall I show you again?
Yes, the syringe.
I should try to show that picture.
How do you incubate it at 70 degrees?
It is incubated in an incubator. Basically, I have a water bath.
Okay.
Water bath. So you have to keep the temperature at 70 degrees.
Okay.
70 degrees. See, this is how we get the biofiller. And what you have to do is that now this is one part of biofiller, means this is going to give the volume to that place. but we want the active element also, so we need to mix it with a PRP. The okay. Buffy coat was PRP, okay? So with okay. the you take the PRP in another syringe, connect it to a three-way cannula, and then you have to just emulsify this PRP with this biofiller.
Okay.
Now it is ready for the injection. So okay. this is about the biofiller.
Okay.